Subscribe to Feminism in India for your dose of intersectional feminist content and make sure to hit the bell icon to get all the latest updates.
Here's your news wrap for the week gone by. Farmers from Punjab who are marching towards Delhi to protest against the central government's farm laws have faced numerous hurdles, including police barriers, tear gas and water cannons. While security has been beefed up significantly in Haryana, many farmers are still continuing their march towards Delhi. Farmers from six states have been planning the protests for 2 months after the centre cleared three laws meant to bring reforms and improve farmers' earnings by allowing them to sell their produce in the commercial market anywhere in the country. The Uttar Pradesh Cabinet approved on Tuesday a draft ordinance outlawing religious conversions by marriage, coercion, deceit or enticement and prescribed up to 10 years imprisonment for those found guilty, becoming the first state to propose a law for regulating interfaith relationships. The announcement came roughly a month after Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath vowed to end love jihad, a term used by right-wing activists to describe marital relationships between Muslim men and Hindu women, but one that the courts and the union government do not officially recognize. Bilkis Bano, fondly known as the Shaheen Bagh Dadi, along with world para badminton champion Mansi Joshi, climate activist Ridhima Pandey, and Ghana singer Isaivani, are among the Indians listed in BBC's 100 Inspiring and Influential Women of 2020. The list, released on Tuesday, was divided into four categories: knowledge, leadership, creativity, and identity. The Delhi High Court has said that an adult woman is free to reside wherever she wishes and with whosoever she wishes. The High Court said this on Wednesday while hearing the habeas corpus plea of a woman filed by her brother who had alleged that his sister was kidnapped. A bench of judges, Vipin Sanghi and Rajneesh Bhatnagar, after interacting with the woman via video conferencing, said the woman, Sulekha, could reside with one Bablu if she so wished. Sulekha was produced in the court via video conferencing, where she said that she left and married Bablu of her own accord. Kerala Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan on Monday said the state government has decided to put on hold the implementation of the Kerala Police Act amendment. This came after a political storm over the controversial amendment to the Police Act. The new law stipulates either imprisonment for up to 5 years or a fine of up to 10,000 rupees or both to those who produce, publish or disseminate content through any means of communication with an intention to intimidate, insult or defame any person through social media. The opposition has alleged that the new law would curtail freedom of expression.